就小开。God, little lake is frozen. You can put a rock on it.Get like a big rock. This is what I was talking about earlier. There's water right over here in this crack. I thought oil might be dripping out. It's in good shape though. Nothing really wrong with it. This is the oil lever. See, now it's actually medium. So that's good. Before it was at the bottom.People with airsoft guns walking around, it's pretty cool. I guess they have an airsoft fight. Pretty sick. But, I'm gonna get going now. Not like home, but I'm gonna let it end a bit more. Hopefully that comes out good, because I don't know, I'm not really feeling it. Like, it must be loud because my exhaust is right there, but I don't know. I'm gonna change it next time. So I found out some new trails right now in the Freetown Reservation. Not myself, but something did like some. Yeah, there's some two-stroke dirt bikes, I can hear them. Alright, but, it really sounds like them, but I'm not sure, because they won't... Maybe not, alright, whatever. I'm trying to take this camera off this mount. Oh, here we go. This is the, well, I stopped right here. Little bit of a problem. See, I don't think my bike's short enough to go underneath that, because I'd like walk it and I'd be on like the side, but yeah, I don't think that's gonna work, but I'm gonna see if I can lift this, and if I can't, then you know, I can't go over there. See, this is what I just went through, this nice straightaway. As you guys probably know because of the reverse camera, but I'm gonna try to lift this tree. Yeah, it's not budging. But anyways, not going over there. The tree is so weak that I can literally just kick it and it falls apart like that. I want to see if like I can do it enough to the point where it actually like breaks in half. But it's hard right there. That's like solid. And I can hear two-stroke dirt bikes, but again, like, it's fooling me because it really doesn't sound like it. Like, I'm actually paying attention now, and I'm like, oh, wait, no, it's the cars on the highway. But I think I, oh, yeah, check that out. Oh, no, never mind. About to say, I can probably come through here, but that's really tight. And there's another tree over there. So I'm just going to continue my little trip. What I was gonna do is I was actually gonna go back up to the big rock, like that cliff. I was gonna go up the cliff and like go on top of that, but I saw this trail and I really wanted to be like going down this for a while now, and it's blocked off, so I can't. The dirt bikes can probably they can go over there and, like, no problem. All they have to do is go sideways, you know, just drag the bikes. Maybe not drag them, but they can get under there. That was a little bit harsh right there. I didn't want to break them out, but I think that's good. So I'm going to turn this around and I'm going to drive back that way. I almost lost the bike. I was pushing a little bit too hard. But I think that's good right there. Yeah. Yeah, next time I'm not gonna use this backwards mount. It probably sounds nice with the exhaust, but I don't know, it's just doesn't feel like it's working out like I want it to. So this will be like my first and last probably two-part video that will have this reverse camera situation. this really doesn't like coming off the mount. There we go. It's stuck. I feel this might be the cliff. This is the top of the cliff. People just in time. I'm trying to kill the people. I'm wearing 3 sweatshirts right now. And you can imagine how weird that looks when you have it tucked into your pants. Yeah, kinda freaking people out, I think. Those are 2 people right over there. There were this one guy who was like a photographer and some one chick who was like walking down the cliff. Which you can do. It's super dangerous. I mean, that's like life and death right there. If you fall, that's like solid ice. That's like not even an inch thick, so it doesn't matter, but you'll probably die of hypothermia if you stay in there too long and you don't know where to swim. You'll probably drown too, but yeah. My rear light can't shut off. So if you guys see like right at the bottom here on the video, I just mess with the light. I think I'm just gonna disconnect it. I don't know, but my rear brake is messed up because when it goes down, it doesn't go back up. See, and this is for the light. So when that goes up, I don't know why it doesn't. I don't know, like, stop like being red. Always red no matter what happens. I have a good amount of gas. Or should I say I think I have a good amount of gas, because I haven't checked yet. But tonight's video. There we go. It's like it broke it. Crap. There we go. I have plenty of gas. You know why I have plenty of gas and I've been riding for so long? Is I haven't been twisting the throttle enough and haven't been draining much fuel. Because if you stay in a higher PM, you're just draining more fuel. You're burning it quicker. Little tip. If you want to extend your riding time, just don't put your bike in such a high RPM. Unless you're riding a 2-stroke, then you kind of have to. That's where the power band is. In the high RPM. So. I'm really determined to like find new trails. That's what I'm doing right now.